हेलो एवरीवन, व्हाट वाज द डिस्कशन इन द प्रीवियस क्लास? वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एंगल बाइसेक्टर्स एंड एन एप्लीकेशन बेस्ड ऑन दैट, राइट? इवन आई गिव यू ए शॉर्टकट टेक्निक व्हाइल डूइंग द एप्लीकेशंस ऑन एंगल बाइसेक्टर्स, ओके? Today, in continuation to that, some more concepts are left. Okay, let us discuss. For suppose, see, so far what we have been discussing in case of the angle bisectors, if we are talking about the acute angle bisector and obtuse angle bisector, okay, two methods we have discussed. If this is obtuse angle bisector and it is acute angle bisector, the way how to trace out them. You have very clear clarity. And coming to the next case, for suppose you are given with some point, let's say px1 y1. This point is there in which region? Acute angle bisector region or obtuse angle bisector region? Means, if at all this point px1 y1 lies somewhere here, then we say obtuse angle bisector region. And if this point px1 y1 lies in the region somewhere here or somewhere here, okay, then we say acute angle bisector region. Either this or this comes under which region? Acute angle bisector, obtuse angle bisector, and means in a simple way you try to remember. If at all you notice obtuse angle bisector, okay, and you notice that this particular point is located somewhere here, then we say it is in the obtuse angle bisector region. And it is somewhere here, then we say acute angle bisector region. So how to decide that? In what particular region the given point lies? Otherwise, the question may be framed like this. Okay. Find the angle bisector in which px1, y1 lies. Getting my point? Such kind of questions may be framed here. That's the reason. Please note down. The equation of the bisector of the angle which contains a given point. I was telling you the same. Which contains a given point, in the sense, or suppose you are given with the point px1 y1, the bisector which contains this, means whether acute angle bisector or obtuse angle bisector, of the angle which contains a given point, okay, that is the underlying point here. Okay, now you write the point. The equation of the bisector of the angle between the equation of the bisector of the angle between the two lines containing the point x1 y1, the two lines containing the point x1 y1 is a1x plus b1y plus c1 by square root of a1 square plus b1 square is equal to a2x plus b2y plus c2 by square root of a2 square plus b2 square. Square root of a2 square plus b2 square. Or a1x plus b1y plus c1 by square root of a1 square plus b1 square is equal to माइनस ए टू एक्स प्लस बी टू वाई प्लस सी टू बाई स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ ए टू स्क्वायर प्लस बी टू स्क्वायर, स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ ए टू स्क्वायर प्लस बी टू स्क्वायर अकॉर्डिंग एज ए वन एक्स वन प्लस बी वन वाई वन प्लस सी वन, ए वन एक्स वन प्लस बी वन वाई वन प्लस सी वन एंड ए टू एक्स वन प्लस बी टू वाई वन प्लस सी टू, ए टू एक्स वन प्लस बी टू वाई वन प्लस सी टू आर ऑफ द सेम साइंस आर अपोजिट साइंस, आर ऑफ द सेम साइन आर अपोजिट साइंस. आई थिंक यू डिंट अंडरस्टैंड एनीथिंग हियर. ओके डोंट गेट कंफ्यूजन. ओके लेट मी गिव यू क्लैरिटी. गिवन पॉइंट पी एक्स वन वाई वन ओके विल बी देयर इन एनी ऑफ द एंगल बाइसेक्टर आइदर दिस आर दिस. फाइन टू ट्रेस आउट दैट पर्टिकुलर इक्वेशन वेदर दिस आर दिस वॉट वी आर सपोज टू डू in the given two lines just put this point x1 y1. see we are given with the lines a1 x plus b1 y plus c1 and a2 x plus b2 y plus c2. so x and y replaced by x1 y1. so a1 x1 plus b1 y1 plus c1, a2 x1 plus b2 y1 plus c2 ee rendu kuda calculate cheyandi. and if at all these two are of the same sign, same sign in the sense this outcome is positive and this outcome is positive or this outcome is negative, this outcome also should be negative, then we say both are of same sign. if at all are rendu kuda same sign avute then the bisector which is containing this point is given by this point. okay next if at all you are getting opposite signs means if this is positive and this is negative then you will be taking this particular case to trace out the angle bisector which is containing the point px1 y1. now oka vela ee vache rendu outcomes positive aina negative aina ee case rendu opposite signs aithe okati plus ay okati minus aithe ledha okati minus okati plus avuthe then you will be going with this case. understand this is how we are going to find out the angle bisector which contains the given point, that point may be the origin also whatever the case. okay even you write a problem based on this so that you will have clarity. for the yesterday's problem only let's calculate what the bisector which is containing the point. for the straight lines for the straight lines 4x plus 3y minus 6 equal to 0 4x plus 3y minus 6 equal to 0 5x plus 12y plus 9 equal to 0 5x plus 12y plus 9 equal to 0 find the equation of the bisector of the angle which contains 1 comma 2 of the angle which contains the point 1 comma 2. hope you got clarity. ikkada correct ga mana question enti ee 1 comma 2 ane point ee angle region lo untundi acute angle region obtuse angle region adi edo reason aithe అదని ఈక్వేషన్ ఏంటి చూడండి ఒకసారి. వాట్ డి ఐ టెల్ యూ వెన్ యూ ఆర్ గివెన్ విత్ ద లైన్ ఈక్వేషన్స్ ఫస్ట్ యూ ఆర్ సపోజ్ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్ ద సైన్ నేచర్ ఆఫ్ ది బోత్ ద ఈక్వేషన్స్ ఆన్ సబ్స్టిట్యూటింగ్ బోత్ ద ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్స్ on substituting the point 1, 2. Chalo. What is the expression value for 4x plus 3y minus 6? 4 into 1 plus 3 into 2 minus 6. 4 plus 6 minus 6 gets cancelled, which is equal to 4. So, when we substituted the point 1, 2, we are getting the outcome as positive. Okay. Next, coming to case 2. 5x plus 12y plus 9 is equal to 5 into 1 plus 12 into 2 plus 9. 5 plus 24 plus 9. Okay. Anyway, all the signs are positive, so the outcome is going to be positive. As I am the concord also direct to the coordinates positive, any terms positive, direct to positive. So very clearly both the expressions are of the same sign. When both are of same sign, which one will take as the bisector which is containing the 1, 2 plus sign? Between the two expressions, we are going to take the plus sign. In such kind of cases, if you get opposite sign, then you will take minus sign. Let's calculate it. Four x plus 3y minus 6y square root of 4 square plus 3 square is equal to plus of 5x plus 12y plus 9 by square root of 5 square plus 12 square. If you simplify this, you are going to get the requirement. Any difficulty here? Nothing, no difficulty here. Yeah, the one thing, the initially you are going to calculate the case whether the points are going to be positive or not. That's very, very important. Understand? In case of positive or in case of negative, then only you will take plus. Otherwise, you will take minus. On simplifying this, you will be getting 9x minus 7y minus 41 equal to 0. What is that? 9x minus 7y minus 41 equal to 0. This is how we are going to trace out the acute angle bisector equation, obtuse angle bisector equation, and the bisector which is containing the given point. When calculating the bisector equations of acute or obtuse, I told you two methods. One is finding the angle between them. If at all theta lies between 0 and 45, then acute angle bisector region. Otherwise, if tan theta lies between 0 and 1, acute angle bisector. If tan theta is greater than 1, obtuse angle bisector. Okay. And even I said you the method of a1a2 plus b1b2 also. And in case of the point nature for the given angle bisector for the given point, we calculate the expressions value. If both are of same sign, plus sign between the two expressions, and if both are of opposite sign, you will be taking the minus sign. Okay. This is how we will be dealing with angle bisectors, one of the most important concept in straight lines and pair of straight lines. Okay, we will also go for some more applications based on this particular thing. And most of the students are asking me about the parametric equations. Okay, nothing confusion here, listen carefully. In this lecture, I want to clear with that also, because yesterday also some of the students posted me. Parametric equation, in the sense, what did I tell you? X minus x1 by cos theta is equal to y minus y1 by sin theta is equal to r. Otherwise, mod r I said you. Why? What is the reason that I said you mod r? The distance will never be negative. That's the reason we are taking under modulus, where r is the distance actually. Then, any point on that line we are taking as x is equal to x1 plus mod r cos theta, and y is equal to y1 plus mod r sin theta. X is equal to x1 plus mod r cos theta, and y is equal to mod r plus y1 plus mod r sin theta. This x comma y may be any point on that particular line. Adi ela teeskuntunnam manam, I told you the very clear picture from this. Let's consider the point P is x1, y1, and let's say it is a collection of the points x comma y. Okay, the distance between these two we are taking as r. That's the reason mod r we have taken. And to trace out these ratios, I have taken the construction from both P, Q and this case also. And this particular line is making some angle theta, so that this also making some angle theta. Fine. This is our total length x and this is of x1. So this is going to be x minus x1. So this is also x minus x1. Similarly, this is going to be y minus y1. Now if you take cos theta in this triangle, you will get x minus x1 by mod r. Because cos theta nothing but adjacent by radius. Sorry, the hypotenuse. And sin theta means opposite by hypotenuse. Okay, that's the reason. X minus x1 by mod r is equal to cos theta. Y minus y1 by mod r is equal to sin theta. Okay. In both the cases, since mod r is going to be of two these two equal ratios, both the cases we are going to be equal. So that we have got x minus x1 by cos theta is equal to y minus y1 by sin theta is equal to mod r. If at all you have this point in the lower direction, the same distance r but we consider as minus r, since minus r will never be, minus r will never be considered as a distance, we will be taking under modulus. So mod minus r is equal to plus r. That is only the difference here. Parametric equation in the sense which you are writing in terms of the distance as well theta. That is x minus x1 by cos theta is equal to y minus y1 by sin theta is equal to mod r. From that you will be taking the both plus case and minus case. In case of plus or minus case, you will be getting x equal to x1 plus or minus r cos theta, y is equal to y1 plus or minus sin r sin theta. For suppose if this point you are taking as x1 plus r cos theta comma y1 plus r sin theta, this point you will take as x1 minus r cos theta comma y1 minus r sin theta. Upper case lo meer plus teeskunte, lower case lo minus teeskuntaru. Lower case lo plus teeskunnaru anukondi, upper case lo minus teeskuntaru. If at all you are taking this point as x1 minus r cos theta comma y1 minus r sin theta, this case you will take x1 plus r cos theta comma y1 plus r sin theta. If this you are taking x1 plus r cos theta comma y1 plus r sin theta, this you will take x1 minus r cos theta comma y1 minus r sin theta. That is the reason we are taking plus or minus, since we are talking about the opposite directions. There is no complications at all. Okay. And that point can be considered anywhere on this particular line, since because we are talking about x comma y. X comma y is a collection of points. Okay. That x comma y can be considered anywhere on this particular line, so that we can go for our requirement. This is how we talk about the parametric equations or symmetric form of the line also we call. Okay. Don't worry about such kind of smaller areas. Okay. Think properly. Definitely you will get corrected easily. Understand? Write a small problem based on angle bisectors and try for that. Please revise the concepts well before going to start solving the application. Find the acute angle bisector between the lines. Find the acute angle bisector between the lines. Sorry for the delay. Find the acute angle bisector between the lines. 3x minus 4y minus 5 equal to 0. And 5x plus 12y minus 26 equal to 0. Five x plus 12y minus 26 equal to 0. Very simple problem. A small problem I gave you here. Nothing complex. You are just going to find the acute angle bisector for the given two lines. You are already aware of the concept. Okay. just see all the conditions and find the bisector equation. Only one problem, not more than that. Just you try this. If you are able to do, I will go with some more applications in the next lecture, and I will give you some more applications. Okay, but please be confident in case of the concepts what we are dealing. Don't lose confidence at any point of time. That is very, very important thing in students. Okay, and some of the new students are there, okay, who joined recently. I suggest them to watch the previous lectures. Okay, then only you go ahead with the present concepts. Otherwise, you can't understand the things what I am teaching you over here. Okay, thank you.